the topic for today is, what are the top things NRI should keep in mind while searching for a job in India? I'm Nupur Dave. I'm an ex-Googler and an NRI, and I've written two books, one of which is a guide to NRIs to move back to India. There's a small print to all of this. One is that your mileage may vary, and obviously these are out of my experience, so there may be biases, but I would suggest you take it with a pinch of salt. The first point is, for NRIs to get their salary expectations right, a lot of NRIs assume or think that for their profile they should be getting around 60 or 70 lakh per annum, whereas the truth is, for their kind of profile, only 30 or 40 lakh is the market rate. I would highly encourage NRIs to find out from talking to some of their friends or looking on glassdoor.com or actually interviewing and getting an offer to see what you would actually get paid in India. The number one reasons why people abort their move to India is because of their salary. The second point is, you don't have to get that perfect salary. You can probably move to India with the salary that is offered to you, and you can always negotiate for more later once you start working with them, or you can always change your job and get a better salary. The third point is, you don't really have to have a job to move to India. You can absolutely move without a job. In fact, I would encourage people to move, take 2-3 months off, just explore India, settle in, and then start searching for a job. In fact, it's advantageous because if you're physically present here in India, it may be easier for you to get a job. So don't fret if you're abroad and you're not getting a job. Don't panic about it. Take your time. The fourth point is, do communicate your decisions as early as possible to the people that you've interviewed with. I've heard from quite a few recruiters in India where they've had NRIs interview for very senior positions in India and then gone completely cold or then decided not to move. The fifth point is, don't assume that because you're an NRI, you're going to get a better deal. I know you probably don't. You may be a very humble person, but there is a certain sect of NRIs who think that they deserve more because they have worked or studied abroad. The world is flat, and a lot of people in India also have exposure abroad. I know maybe you're not like this, but there are certain people like this, and that's the feedback that I've got from some recruiters. The sixth point is that be ready for a different set of questions that recruiters may ask you in India. One biggest example of the difference between recruiting in the US and India was that a lot of recruiters, in fact, I would say about 50% of the companies that I interviewed with asked me questions that would be illegal in America. The most prominent one being your marital status. So you may want to be prepared with an answer to that. There are some people who ask you directly. There are some people who find a way around asking you indirectly, like, so who's at home? Part B to this is, what is your expected salary? Is a question that they are going to absolutely ask you. In fact, some recruiters don't move forward till you've told them what you expect. There are ways you can deal with this. Either give them the answer that they're looking for, or you could give them a range if you're not comfortable. You could say, maybe I'm expecting between 25 to 30 lakhs per annum. There are more details in my book. I hope this has helped you. This is Nupur Dave signing off from nupurdave.in. Please buy my book, buy 5 copies and gift it to your friends.